of precarity in a lot of European countries is very difficult because it means different things across Europe. In a country like my country of origin, which is Bulgaria, even the term is not translatable. We can probably use guy standings precariat, but to speak of precarity, we don't have a proper term and it would probably sound unnatural. At the same time, the issue of precarity there is represented on a number of different levels that are more to do with domestic workers, women who are usually women who are exploited within the sector of sewing and tailoring by foreign corporations in order to use the brand of the European Union, made in EU. At the same time, there is a flexibilization, but it is much less related, for example, to the locals working in, say, the telecom centers and so on, because it is mostly foreigners who come and work in that field. At the same time, what is interesting is that precarity, and this has been discussed a lot in literature, is a term that is very difficult to, employ in a broader context than a few Fordist and post-Fordist, post-welfare state countries within the European Union and the global north. It is a concept that tries to bridge together two broad struggles, starting from very highly ranked workers in industries and cultural workers, banking sector and so forth. So it tries to bring together struggles that are not of the same side. And at the same time, what my interviews in Ireland of workers in academia tell me is that many times it is the less precarious people who are the salariat in terms of guy standing, so the people who have pensionable salaries with benefits and everything feel more and more exploited, and they call themselves precarious and are comparing themselves to domestic workers or to all sorts of workers on much less secure conditions. And so thinking that precarity is a shared condition historically, globally, in most of human history and most of the world is, I think, something important to bear in mind. And at the same time, it is important that this term has gained certain momentum within European movements, and if it can be used with its limitations to bring together struggles of different orders, why not use it?